Right, let's do this. Evil team, of course. Right, I think we just start the timer when we hit go here, so I guess in 3, 2, 1, go. Finally playing this game. Say, it does look a bit weird on my TV, but it'll do. It's a bit brighter than I'm used to, let's put it that way. So we have already hit 10 Wampa, that's good. Crap. Right, I got blue shield, that's very good. For me to only hit my own nitro box, of course. Oh crap, come on, come on, come on. Where did the ice come from? Excuse me, that's illegal, you must stop. Thought be gone. Okay, sweet. Race one down. Oh crap, I drove right past the thing. That was a close one. Almost messed up big time. Oh geez, I went way too wide that time. Oh, are you kidding me? That's not fair. That was completely fair, actually. That was me just being an idiot. This is one of those games where it's kind of funny, it's faster to be faster. Because since you're ahead of the pack, then the game will lag less. Oh, you, what was that? That doesn't happen. Okay, good. Got back to first. Of no success of my own, but we are back in first, and that is an objective fact. So now let's try and build a lead for ourselves that we should have been doing on the first lap. So we got a left turn coming up here. The left. And left turn to finish line. Good! We won. That is a success. Okay, so let's go the right way this time, so it's in here. Ooh, tiny temple, let's do this. I really don't want Coco to win this. There we go, okay, good, that went well. Ooh, crunk. Let's do this. So what seems to be the key to Krunk is just staying ahead. Because if you fall behind on Krunk, then you are dead. Luckily for me, I have two shields. And some TNT. That is very nice. Yeah, I kind of figured it'd be better to get both of us there. Because I knew he was going to overtake me anyway, because I think he's just faster. So I figured it was best to stop us both in our tracks. Oh! Oh, I glitched him! So, in this game, if you fall off the track, like fall off a ledge or something, onto a different section of the track, it'll essentially put you like half a lap behind. Yeah, now we have literally nothing to worry about this in this run. This is just a time trial. That's so funny, I didn't even know that could happen to the CPUs. I mean, I will be honest though, I did expect him to be catching up by now. Okay, well that was amazing. Amazing for the wrong reasons, but that was still pretty good, I think. Right, let's return to the hub world. And on to Baron. Baron isn't too bad a world if I remember right. I'm gonna start off by going here, and we're gonna cycle back around. No, this is a lovely one. It's just right angles. Oh crap, and we didn't get the speed boost. Which means we've got a lot of lag to deal with at the start of this. Unless we boost ahead like that, which was lovely. Jeez, Crash got equipped there. Oh crap, I drifted the wrong way. That was bad. Ooh, that was a good time thing though. And I didn't time the throwing out the nitro box correctly, so now I'm itemless. But I think there's items somewhere around here, which makes that fine. And that was a bit scary. And of course we get ice, of course we get ice. Because why would we get any useful item? We could get like a defensive rear item, we could get like a boost item. No, no, we get the icicle. Again, really? I guess this really is the ice world. Whew. Whew, that was pretty good, I must say. Oh crap, that was it. I thought I was driving past a different thing. Oh, and I missed the boost again as well. Jeez, am I really last at the moment? Wow. Feels bad, man. That is not what you want to happen in your lap 3. And that's not the kind of item you want to get when you're in last place and coming up near the end. Yeah, no, there's no chance of catching up there. That sucks. Oh, and I missed it again. Crap. No, crap, I wasn't paying attention. I don't know why they put blue shields and green shields in Nitro Kart. Like, those are just straight out of Sonic. It's like the same tiering of shields as well, you go green then blue. Kinda wanna let him overtake you. No, I don't. I didn't realize how close I was to the end there. I was gonna say, I was gonna let him overtake so I could shoot a missile at him. But I did not realize he was so close. I mean, we were close, so close to the end. And I missed the thing again. Great. But that's alright, in this one it doesn't matter too much. Just a lot of lag near the beginning. Especially when I throw a bomb like this. Oh, I had three bombs, I did not realize. Probably would have thrown another one earlier if I realized. Right, final lap. This should be fine. We have a decent lead, at least. I'm not sure what caused all the lag there. That was weird. And across the line. There we go. Nash's challenge. Oh, I forgot a mash here. We could probably use the GameCube controller for mash, that one's easier to do it on. So if I remember right, Nash is like the first boss who's a pain. Like, him and the Gear boss are actually the only ones who really serve difficulty, aside from Velo. And there's no way of gimping him like there is the other boss. Alright, let's do this. Come on, we need to catch up here. No, oh, you're kidding me. Let's do this. So it's like my options were don't hop, because if you don't hop, the TNT will explode. Or hop and fall off the cliff. I chose the latter solely because it would allow me to respawn faster. So this game has slightly advantageous rubber banding in the player's favor, where the boss will actually go a little bit slower if he's ahead of you. But he's very quick to catch up if he's behind. And there we go. That was alright. On to Phenomena. Ooh, here we go. No, oh, are you kidding me? I thought I got it there. But I must have missed it slightly. Oh, it's not that road. That is the end of the level. So that's great. That means we can just zoom straight to first, get past the entire scrum, and then just be lagless for the rest of the race, hopefully. Assuming all goes to plan, which it doesn't, because I drove way into the path of the ditch there. Make that actually matter for anything. So here we purposely drive into the ditch so that we can take that corner tight enough. And we don't jump there because otherwise we fall in the pit like that. Which is something you don't do. Oh, I jumped way too early for that corner. Tried to adjust, but it didn't quite work out, it seems. I think I was a bit too far there, but that worked. Except I missed the ramp that time. Oh really? Entropy caught up? Oh crap. Come on. So in the plus side, in this game, the bombs have like a slight homing mechanism to them. Probably to make up for the fact that it's very hard to tell distance and such on the Game Boy Advance. However, in the downside, the bombs have a homing mechanism, which makes any boss that throws bombs, i.e. the World 4 boss, nigh impossible. So unless you like start ahead of him, you're basically screwed for the entire race. No, we don't lose the race this way. We may lose the race, but this is not how we do it. Ooh, that was a close one. Less than a second between me and Entropy. Now here's the only course in the game where I watch the mini-map instead of the actual stage. It's only because it's that confusing. And has no landmarks whatsoever. Ah, oh, crap, I was supposed to get a boost there. But this works. Oh, crap. Hit the wall. See, how was Entrance keeping up with me there when I was using a boost? Unless he was also using a boost. Which I doubt. Okay, I'm not sure even what hit me there. Must have been a bomb from behind or something. Okay, hopefully we see Entrance in a second so we can shoot this missile at him. Nope, and I jumped way too early and I realized it and I tried to correct it and it didn't quite work out. It's not very helpful. Right, so I'm actually going to need to just rely on driving for this. And just being inherently faster as well seems to help. Thunderstruck. This wasn't too bad. There is a few places where it can just go so wrong though. Also, I think this song was used in Crash Fusion. See, that's when this track can be a pain. But usually it's not too bad. Hopefully someone hits that nitro box, because if no one does, then I won't be able to take that boost panel next round. Forgot I had a shield there, and it would have been quite nice to keep that shield, but oh well. We have another one, it seems. And we missed the jump. No, didn't need to hit that. But we are so far ahead that it doesn't really matter. We just want to be fast. Okay, there we go. Norm's challenge. There we go. Okay, let's do this. Norm isn't too bad. He's one of the easier bosses, it seems. Except when you mess up. See, the fun bit about Norm is, since there's two of them, they can hit each other. So it's a nice way of clearing up some of the TNT and the just general hazards around the map. Yeah, that's what I was meaning about the bombs earlier. I didn't realize these guys threw bombs. I couldn't remember them throwing bombs, at least. But when they do throw bombs, it seems to be fairly infrequent. Yeah, and that's what I'm meaning about having to hop to get rid of the TNT crate. It can be painful, to say the least. Although it does seem like we have glitched one of the norms. When I say we, I mean I think he kind of did it by himself. Yeah, so we'll see, one of the other norms is just at the other side of the track, so we have one less guy to worry about, it seems. So here's the thing, if the other norm gets glitched out, then this is just in the bag. Oh, come on. Oh, come on. We can do this. Let's not lose the race here. At least that was near a boost panel, so we could catch back up. There we go, okay. Ooh, so many TNTs. This is not fun. Right, we have a bomb, which means if he's a bit ahead of us, we can kind of stomp him. Like here, for example. Here he is a bit ahead, so we need to catch up slightly. We can probably do that here. Oh, and he seems to have stumped himself. That's fine. I did kind of want to hit him with a bomb sometime around here. Unfortunately, the bomb seems to have missed, but I think we're still good. No! That was 0.04 seconds. We lost to him by 0.04 seconds. Holy crap. That's not okay. Okay, so I think one of the bosses screwed himself over like last time, because he seems to be significantly behind. Where are we? We are here. Ooh, okay, it's going better, it's going better. candy. Oh, come on. And he spawns right next to a boost panel as well, of course he does. Okay, there's a few items which can allow us to catch up here. Nothing like that, though. That was an early turn as well. Crap. We can still gimp him. Not with an ice cube, though. We need a box, and we need a good item. We need either a bomb or a rocket. Or I think we might have lost this. Shield, that's even better. Because this can be used defensively as well. Okay, there we go. Holy crap, that felt bad, man. Android Alley. This track isn't too bad. Okay, that was as expected, really. There's not much that can go wrong during that track. Alright, come on, Dingodile, overtake. Overtake Dingodile. Oh, that's a corner. I thought we were going straight ahead there. My bad, my bad. There we go, there's Dingodile. Okay, I let go of right trigger there to redrift, and it just didn't go through, and I'm not sure why. There was ice there, really? Come on. Oh no, this is the last lap as well. At least we're in second, we can catch up here. Ooh, there we go. Beat Dingodile by 0.3 seconds. Electron Avenue. This one's lovely and simple. Like, I wish there were more tracks like this one. Oh, it doesn't help when you drift the wrong way, though. Or do that. I need to stop jinxing myself. Wow, the scrum is staying together in this one. Like, no one's really fallen behind. And no one's really pulled out in front either. Which is not going to be very good for the lag. There we go, that's much better. Where was that ice? Okay, yeah, fair enough, I hit him there. No, but I'm like, where was the ice? Actually, I did not see any ice on screen. Oh, we're back at the back of the scrum again. Excuse me, what hit me there? How did that missile not aim for anyone? There was literally four people in front of me. Oh, wow, that was a shame. Okay, here we go. Now we're in front. Now we're in business. Okay, we've hit crunch onto the last lap. No, we didn't, apparently. Getting the stop clock in first place is just so broken. Oh, come on. Okay, there we go. I think that's Techni finished. Hopefully Geary doesn't give me too many problems. Come on, let's do this. Well, that is lovely. That's... Oh, if I actually used it, that would be lovely. And if I stayed on course, that would be great too. Ah, man. Geary's the worst. Literally, I would say he's the worst boss in this game significantly. As in difficult, but unfair difficult. Like, not interesting difficult. Not you need to just be play better difficult. As in, you just need to hope you get a good item and win the difficult. Because if you get close enough to where the bombs start aiming, and you don't have some sort of like protection, then you are as good as dead, my friend. Ooh, yeah, that's how I figured that would go. Oh, I was hoping to hit him there with the thing. Never mind. We'll try again next lap when he inevitably catches up. And that time I had no chance of catching up. Oh my god, I just got bodied at the beginning of that. Giri, please! Give me mercy, give me mercy. Stop stealing my box. I need that box to defeat you. It's like, how are you supposed to react to that? How? It's like, how are you supposed to compete with this? Yeah, this boss makes me legitimately mad that he's in the game. Like, who let this be happening? Like, someone looked at this and was like, this is okay. You know? So they're like, oh, he throws bombs in the on the console version. You know, let's make him just throw bombs in this. Not remembering that they changed the bombs to be homing in this. Do I continue this one? I sure do. Because I mean, one good item can change it, I guess. If that missile actually homed on and got him, then I would have got it, but no. So like the fact that he can throw the bombs forward as well is just the stupidest bit. Like, he is super rubber banding to catch up. But then he can also throw bombs at you to slow you down. I mean, you can catch up to the point because the rubber banding, but you can't catch up to the point of actually being able to do anything because the bombs. Plus off-screen bombs that you literally just can't react to. Like, what are you supposed to do to that? You can't react in time. No, I was a little too early when it came to shooting that missile. Otherwise that would have been him gimped and I would have just won this one. No! And I had a shield there as well, that would have been perfect. Oh my, come on! Is there some kind of secret that, like, I just don't know about this boss? Okay, I was hoping to for him not to just stop there, but okay. Sure, I'll take it. Okay, I'm not sure why he's so far behind. He's usually a better driver than this. And I fell off because I'm an idiot. No, 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 this isn't okay, this isn't okay. We've almost won. We've almost won. Yes, okay, we did it. Okay, now just for Velo. He's like, Velo throws bombs, but most of the time he doesn't, which makes it okay. No! Oh, less than a second between us, come on. Oh, come on, that's a bit of ground scenery. That's not a thing. I need to go knocked off. Come on, Tiny, you can do this. That is pretty stupid. No, come on. I just want to finish this run, man. I mean, we're so close. Just like 10 minutes of choke on Velo. Okay, I don't know what I could have done differently with that TNT. That one was a bit weird. Because I did start hopping instantly, but it didn't go through. Come on, I need an item, and I need one now. I thought I threw that early enough to get another box, but apparently I didn't. I mean, yeah, it probably was ratio for Dan. I'm just very salty at the moment. It wasn't, sorry, I didn't quite catch what the context of that was. Oh, you've got a kappa. Oh, okay, that makes a bit more sense. Oh, come on. Oh, and God's like, oh, okay, no, that makes sense. Sorry, yeah, I know, there's just a bit of a chat delay, so I wasn't quite sure what you're referring to. So we can still win this, we just need to catch up. We need a good item here. That was probably the best item in the game we could have gotten in that scenario, aside from invincibility. Ooh, we did it! 128-42. The final split took 14 minutes, it should have took 3. Oh, that was a bit of a meme. Oh, that was a bit of a meme. Ratio 4 Dan. That name rings a bell. I've probably seen you around somewhere. I don't think I've seen you around here though. You almost bought this. Well, don't make the mistake I did of buying it twice. You know. Because there's a cartridge that's in the GameCube. And then there's this one. I mean, it's not actually that bad a game, to be honest. Aside from the final boss and the boss of Girna? Is it Girna? No, Techni. Yeah, the bosses of Techni and Velo are a pain in the ass. But apart from that, this game is actually pretty fun, and the relics are super hard. Like, this game is really